Hello, scientific writers. In this video, I'm going to show you an easy way to quickly customize your NIH biosketch. Hi, this is Brian from the Grants and Publications YouTube channel. Now, making a customized NIH biosketch for every application is a good idea. When you customize your biosketch for each project, it helps the reviewers see why you are uniquely qualified to carry out the role you have in that proposed project. And there are different parts that you have to customize. There's the personal statement, and then the contributions to science might be a little bit different depending on what you're doing in various projects. You might want to highlight different publications or research products that you produced in the past. So I'm going to show you how to use some software from the National Library of Medicine that's called SciENcv to make your biosketch very quickly. Now, you can just type the information in to this template that the NIH provides, which is in a Word document format, and then just save it with a different name. But if you would like to try the SciENcv, I find it very handy because it does more than just an NIH biosketch. We'll look at that right now, and I'll show you what I mean. All right, so this is what the NCBI webpage looks like, and this is where we're going to enter the system to get to SciENcv. You need to have an account with NCBI, so just go up here to sign in. All right, so now I'm signed in. I'm going to go up here to the top of the screen and click My NCBI. One thing you want to start out with is My Bibliography. So click Manage My Bibliography. What you're going to do is add all of your citations. So I'm going to search from PubMed, and I will enter my last name and initials, and I will search. Okay, so here are some of my publications. So I can select those and I can click Add to My Bibliography. Not all of my publications were found in PubMed, so I'm going to add some of them manually. So we can just type in the title of the article, the authors, and you can just add more authors if you have multiple authors, the journal, the publication date, the volume, the issue, the page, the URL, the unique ID, the type of unique ID, if you have one of those. So here are a lot of choices. There's a DOI, an ORCID, etc. So you see all the choices you have here. Now recall when you're filling out your biosketch that you can add publications or research products. So what are research products? They can include, but are not limited to, audio or video products, conference proceedings, patents, data and research materials, databases, educational aids or curricula, instruments or equipment, models, protocols, software or netware, or interim research products such as preprints. Now, one of the nice things about My Bibliography is it's not only for publications. You can add these other research products as well. So how do you add other research products? You can just go here to Add Citations, and say manually, then choose the type of citation to create. So you can add a book or chapter, a meeting abstract, a presentation, a patent, a data set or a database, software, preprint, or other. Select the type and fill out the fields as appropriate. Once you have your bibliography complete, go back to My NCBI, and now we're going to go here to SciENcv, and we're going to say Manage SciENcv, and you can say Create a New Document. Give the document a name, and then you can choose the format. You can do an NIH biosketch, an NIH fellowship biosketch. You can also do an NSF biosketch, an NSF current and pending support, or an IES biosketch. So we're going to go with an NIH biosketch, and then we can say start with a blank document or start with an existing document or an external source, such as ERA Commons. But we're going to just start with a blank document, and we're going to keep it private for now. So let's say create. And now we can start filling in the fields. The name field is already filled in. The education and training, we need to click Add. Personal statement, we need to edit that. And then we can select citations. For positions, scientific appointments and honors, we can add those by clicking here. And we can add the honors by clicking here. And for contributions to science, we can fill that out by clicking here. All right, just to save some time, I'm going to go with an NIH biosketch I've already partially filled out. So we have the name. If I want to link it to an ERE Commons account, I can click that. For education and training, I have one entry. So let's go ahead and add another degree and training. So this is a degree, and I'll just fill this out. All right, so I've filled out the information, and I will click Save and Add Another Entry because I have to put in my bachelor's degree, or if that was my last degree, I could just click Save. Okay, so I've filled in all my education and training, and I have entered a personal statement. This personal statement is short because in my previous video, I talked about what to put in the personal statement. In this video, I'm just showing you how to use the software. So we have a short personal statement here, and we can select some citations to add to it as is allowed. So I'm just going to go to my oldest ones and select 4. For the purposes of this video, I'm not putting a lot of thought into which citations I'm going to add here. When you do your biosketch, do put a lot of thought into it. All right, so once you have selected the citations, go up here and say Save Citations. So now those will appear with my personal statement. Next, we have positions and scientific appointments. So I have listed some of my positions back to 2008, but I'm going to add one more entry to show you how this works. So I'll go to Edit Entries and then add another entry. So I've filled in the information and I click Save. Let's add some honors here. So I'll just add one honor. And we'll save that. And if you want to add additional ones, just click Add Another Entry. Then we'll move to the Contributions to Science section. And you can see I've already added one with my description and citations. So let's say edit this section, and I will add another contribution. So for the description, I need to say edit, and then I'll paste in my text. And then click the green check mark to save it. And then select the citations that I want to designate as relevant to this contribution. So I've selected 4 citations here, and I'm going to save citations. And do I want to include a link to the complete list of published work in my bibliography? Yes, so I have checked this box. It shows the link here. So that's it, I'm done. So what I can do now is download this biosketch, and I can do that as a PDF, as a Word document, or as an XML. So I'm going to go with the PDF because that's what I need to submit to NIH. So I click PDF, it prepares my file for download. Downloads, let's open it. And there it is. Okay, so it's all filled out. We have my name, my title, my education and training, my personal statement, positions, specific appointments and honors, contributions to science. I just have 2 of them, and each of those has 4 citations. And then a complete list to my published work. So that's a really easy way to make your biosketch with this software and to customize it each time you make a new biosketch for a different application. I hope that was helpful to you. If you have any questions, you can leave them in the comments below. If you got value from this video, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to the Grants and Publications YouTube channel for more information and tips about scientific writing related topics. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time, and happy writing.